The school owner, Patrick Wanzala, led by his lawyer, Jonathan Abeine, says he sees no reason for the demolition when the matter is in court.
I request that they allow the school to achieve the big tampering. His action of coming at night at 2 a.m. There would have been people, when the security came from his office, if the commander was not in the first, when they were saying fire, there would have been dead bodies there. The same people came very early in the morning and confessed that we are the one who did this. How they recording
it? One side, which is the calling itself landlords, having come to stop the opening of the school by demolishing the buildings. And yet the matters are still pending in court. So we have been called here to come and witness what has happened and also to advise on way forward.
Landowner Dennis Musoke says the contract he had with the school ended in October 2018 and he doesn't recognize Wanzala as his tenant anymore.
Reached even an extent of telling him to buy the land. He can attest to that. Tell him if you really want to buy the land, buy it. You can't steal land like that because you're saying it is school.
Meanwhile, government-aided schools in Barara District have registered a big turn-up of learners compared to private schools on day two of school's reopening. The turn-up excited school heads who thanked parents for allowing their children to report on time. They have promised to keep the children safe from COVID infections.
As far as COVID-19 guidelines as a school, we are fully prepared. Teachers came 2 weeks ago and we have been undergoing training on how to manage cases of COVID-19 outbreak, and we have put SOP materials.
Sister Felicity Nachitio, the headmistress of St. Helens Primary School, encouraged parents whose children are still at home to bring them.
We had almost 1,000, around 1,000 pupils. So exactly we don't know how many will come, but we've been receiving new entrants. We hope to get many pupils this year.
In Iganga District, a disabled girl without hands and legs who excelled in the primary living examinations reported for senior one at Musana Vocational School. Here, she has been offered a full bursary. 16-year-old Petwa, who scored aggregate 7 in PLE, hopes to become an accountant.
I'm feeling well because I'm now at school and I'm going to study through sponsorships. And I'm very happy. I want to appreciate Ms. an organization for the sponsorship.
Petwa was brought to school by her aunt Nanyama Edinansi.
Nebazani family yonena eyamusana abasomesa okungemera ku kyaku waide petu okungemera ku kizibu kye ekyali ekyange kinene nga kyetu isenga nkuba wamba ali naye avulana ye aye musana yakoba ati njya okugemera ku ki.
Her class teacher, Batale Olive, promised to ensure Petwa has a good education experience.
Such a student, we welcome them here in Musana. We are hospitable to them. We love them. That's why Musana Primary has decided to bring even that one here to secondary. And for us, we take good care of them.
In Gulu, the school stationery's businesses are basking in profits with the reopening of schools, reactivating an almost dead venture. Business owners who had little sales in the last 2 years have now run out of stock.
We have taken long without being busy, so we are happy for everything. So we've been here down 2 years without doing business. So that's why you see the business is really very tough. We have been running sort of items. We sold almost everything.
The business venture had been redundant for 2 years after schools closed due to COVID-19.
Trying to buy stocks from Kampala, but things have increased, like photocopying paper, it has gone up, and also there are challenges with customers. They are used to the other normal price, but things have gone high. So it's not easy. We are trying, but...
This has also led to the increase in the price of maize grains, which increased from 800 shillings to 1,000 shillings.
The price of maize at the farm gate is at either 850 or 900. a kilo, and when you come here in town, you will get a kilo at one town per kilo. So the business of maize, at the moment, it is booming, but the unfortunate part, the scarcity is also there.
As the students are going back to to school, the price of ginger, it has increased from a grain one, it's at 3,300, and before it was at 3,200 because demand was low. As you see behind, women are busy also sorting ginger because people are demanding it for paste.
Report by Joseph Omago, Ivan Wachibi, Abdul Karim Sengendo, and Sharon Navasirie.